Whether you came from near or far at the Scottish court, it is most important that we extend to you good hospitality, that whilst you share with us good food, good drink, and good conversation, you therefore are able to make good alliances and good friendship too. And hopefully this would leave you with an opinion that we are a very fine folk, despite being a small kingdom with rather wild weather. We're not really all savages. That too is the point of this palace. My late brother, King James, has built this to show the rest of the world just how sophisticated we can be in Scotland, though he also built it as a wedding present for his beautiful French bride. Her shield is there, above, joined with the King's own. A representation of the marriage between James V and Marie de Guise et Lorraine. I am that lady's sister-in-law, Lady Janet Fleming, though I also serve as governess to their daughter, Mary Queen of Scots, my niece. In truth, I have the rare privilege of being able to tell the Queen of Scots what to do, although she currently is only 4 years old, so it's a bit of a challenge. But never a dull moment, I promise you that. I have often been at court since I was the daughter of James IV, though now I'm married to the great chamberlain of Scotland. My husband is good Lord Malcolm Fleming, 3rd of that title. Currently, though, he is off defending Scotland against attack. We've had a slight disagreement with England about whom our little queen should marry. Henry VIII believes she should marry his son, Prince Edward, for if she does, though she may be queen in her own right, by marrying the Prince of England, that would put Scotland under English authority, which is something we do not admire greatly in this realm. But the English king thinks it a wonderful idea to break in peace with us. The only problem is we have tried brokering peace through marriage before. It didn't work out well. Thus, we have declined the offer of marriage. Unfortunately, the English king does not like to be told no, and so is currently invading Scotland, making war with us to change our mind. I think he does not really understand either women or Scottish people if he thinks that will work. We are very stubborn and can be quite contrary too. But that is where my husband currently resides. He is off elsewhere defending the borders of this realm. Truthfully, he is getting on in years. He might not come back, which would be, of course, quite tragic. But I have been a goodly wife to him. I have given him 6 living children, sons included. Sadly, our eldest son is not quite with us at this moment because, well, he is in England. My husband was captured in the Battle of Stirling in 1542, a battle against England, and in order to gain his liberty, he had to have his heir, our eldest son, handed over to the English as a surety to prove that he would be on the English side in suggesting that marriage union between the Prince of England and our queen. Of course, it has all fallen through, so I do not know when my son would be returned to me. Hopefully, soon. I cannot say if anybody had asked my opinion, I would have said they could have kept my husband and I would have kept our son, but it was not to be. Sounds a little scandalous, but, well, I am of the blood royal, after all. Although, if I'm entirely honest with you, yes, my father was indeed King James IV, but his goodly wife, Margaret Tudor, in fact, not my mother. For good reason. When Margaret Tudor married King James IV of Scots in 1503 to broker peace between the two kingdoms, she was only 13, and the king was 30, so he was being distracted elsewhere. I am not a born child. There is no shame in that. You cannot help your circumstances of birth. We are acknowledged and usually raised in royal palaces and castles, and if you are a lady, very well married off to some rich and noble lord. If you are a gentleman, then perhaps you would be given titles and lands. The Earl of Murray is quite often a natural born son. Or perhaps you would be found a living in the church. But we are still proud of where we come from, and if you see our coats of arms, such children will use the red lion rampant on the golden field, but it will have a bar sinister, a strike through it, to denote that we are not legitimate heirs. Mm-hmm.